Welcome back to my channel, friends. This is Sonia here from Growing Craft, and I hope you all are doing good. So today I'm going to do this pot. Yes, it's a clay pot, which I thought I will do decoupage work technique on this. And this was lying in my balcony since long, so I really had to clean up really well before starting this work. And to start with, I am going to use my white color acrylic paint. Now this pot already had a lid, but I don't want to use this lid as I'm going to keep this on my center table. So I'm just going to do the work on my pot only. Now I am using acrylic paint white color, and I'm going to have two coats of these paint on my pot. The reason why I want to opt for two coats is because being a clay pot, it has its own natural brown color, and which is really really dark, and I wanted a plain white and a really clean surface. So for that I need to have two layers of acrylic color for sure. Now for applying this, I'm using my paintbrush, cause that is actually going to have a really good coverage, and I'm using a fat brush which is really big in size, so it is actually going to make my work super easy and super fast. Now choosing the color for your decoupage projects is a very 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 essential thing. Many a times I've been asked that which colors to use for your background and how to highlight your decoupage tissues. Now for that, the bare minimum, the very basic thing one need to know is that white color always 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 highlights any of the tissue paper colors you have. Even if you have pastel greens, pastel blues, white, cream, off-white, pink, any color, any design, white color always, always, always makes your tissue paper stand out, and it actually makes its color more brighter. Now you can also try out with other colors. I have done couple of videos with different colors also, and end of the day it really matters that what kind of finish you are looking for, what kind of colors you are looking for your project. Now here I am going to have my color on my complete pot. I'm not going to paint it on the inner side, cause anyways I am going to plant something inside this. So I am just going to cover up the top portion of my pot and the complete surrounding of my pot. So this is one of my new decoupage tissue which I got just a couple of days back, and I was so much in love with this design that I thought I will be using this only. So now I am going to just trim off the paper with the help of my scissor. Of lately I have tried this technique, like tearing off your decoupage tissues with your scissor, and I really 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 love this. Still, tearing off your papers with your paintbrushes is one of my favorite thing to do, cause it gives much more natural look to it, but I also like this technique too. Now the best part about these decoupage tissues is that it has four designs, like the four same design on one sheet, so you can actually use these sheets on your four different projects. So with the cost, yes, you definitely save so much, and you have so much of variety of projects what you can create with this one single piece. Like very recently I did floral print work. I did it on glass, I did it on tray, I did it on wine bottle, and trust me, it looks fab. It actually looks like a one complete set which can be used as a table decor piece or any of your decorative piece for any corner of your house, and it just works wonderful. Now I'm going to remove the plies, and this was pretty easy for this one, and now it's time to stick it. Now for this I am going to use my matte finish Mod Podge, and I'm going to make sure that I apply generous amount of Mod Podge and stick my decoupage tissue really well on this. For this complete project I am going to use my flat brush only, cause it is actually going to work really well when it comes to sticking your decoupage tissues or painting your base. I am just going to rub off my tissue along my Mod Podge, and with the brush I am just going to give it a very gentle press, and I am going to make sure that I do not have any bubbles. Of lately I have even realized that even sticking your papers is a little difficult, so what you can do is you can gently press your papers with fingers once your Mod Podge has dried around almost 40-50%. Now here my pot size is a little odd, so I had to cut my tissue paper, but I'm not going to trim off it completely. I'm just going to wrap it up and stick it as it is. I really loved the design, and that's the reason I did not want it to cut any of the design, and I could easily manage with my sticking of decoupage tissue in this. Once it dries out completely, and you can see it's already looking good, but I thought I need to add some stamping to it. I really love this stamp. I love the floral pattern, and it actually it was matching some of the floral pattern which is there in the decoupage tissue. So here I'm using my permanent ink pad. Yes, you need to really make sure that you use your permanent ink pad so that even if you do some work, apply some color shades, or if you do any of the extra work on this, it will not smudge at all. So here I'm using my permanent ink pad, I'm using my stamping, and I'm just doing the random stamping because, like I said, I want to highlight my Buddha. That is going to be more of my focal point. So this is just going to be my filler for my project. So I'm just doing the random stamping here and there. I have chosen the floral stamp. You can even pick the motif stamp, you can even pick the border stamps. They are also going to look really cool in this project too. And now it's time to add some shimmer paint. I have been using these paints since long, and I'm a big fan of these paints, and I thought this pink and golden shade is actually going to match my color really well. Now here is a little thing. I am using my round brush. I have sprinkled so much of water on my pot, and I'm just spreading my color really well. You need to really make sure that you do not sprinkle water or too much water on your decoupage tissue, because definitely we don't want to ruin it. You just need to sprinkle water or add some more extra water to your paint, and you can just spread it on your pot randomly. You can even spread it with your fingers, and it is just going to give an extra color, some extra dimensions to your project. This was my choice of adding colors. You can, even if you leave it plain white, it is going to look beautiful, trust me, because the more highlighting thing is your Buddha, your decoupage tissue, and your stamping. So color is something which you can skip in case if you want to. Now everything is done and my pot has dried out completely, and it's time to add some filler to it. So here I'm using my varnish, and I'm going to give good 2 coats of varnish to it, but I'm going to make sure that after my first layer of varnish, my pot dries out completely well, and then I'm going to apply my second coat. Now with this, my complete project is done, and this is how my pot looks, and I'm super happy, and I never ever expected my pot to look this amazing and this beautiful. So I hope you all enjoyed this tutorial. I'm sharing few more pictures at the end, do check that, and if you have any queries, please do comment below. I'll be more than happy to help you all. Thank you so much for watching this video, and do not forget to share this with your friends. Thank you so much. Take care. Bye bye.